Alright guys, I'm turning on audio for a second here. If you're just joining, you can see, you can probably see what I'm looking at too, which is there's one guy left, a real holdout, sitting on the roof of this building here, just surrounded by what seems to be hundreds of police and Humvees, etc. The police came in this morning and walked through the camp and walked everyone out. You can see there's been all sorts of stuff going on here. Helicopters flying around, there's planes circling overhead. Looks like a movie underneath his helicopter. This guy's got a sniper out the side of the helicopter. All for a bunch of people that are peacefully praying because they don't want an oil spill in their water. Back over here to where we were. Let's check in on this guy. Where are you? There you are. He's still hanging out. Just to give you a quick recap, sorry if it's super windy here, can't really do anything about it. You can see that the camp has been pushed through and cleared. I did not live stream that, I did tape it though. You can see, you know, there's just police everywhere. Hanging out, walking through teepees and checking, making sure that no one's still there, etc. But this is the camp, Oceti, Sakowin, that that a lot of people. That's where I was back in November when I came in briefly. Everything but trains.
They also got the water to this camp as well.
Here,
I used to work.
Going back over. There is the guy. I just think it's kind of funny that he is still. He's still sitting on the roof. areas back here. Bring some hand warmers. It is nice and chilly out here. Nice and chilly out here. It's 60 last week. Back down to negative 10. Or sorry, not negative 10, like 10 degrees. Sorry. Exaggerate here. Guys, leave Taryn alone. She's sad. She's sad. She's taking out on you. Leave her alone. She's got enough to deal with. People, the bottom line, no matter what, people are going to be on both sides of every issue. And it's fine. They're allowed to be on that side. Just, don't feed the trolls, friends. Don't feed the trolls. Let's keep it positive. Still got a dude on the roof. Just joining. We're here at a Oceti Sakowin camp, Standing Rock Reservation, North Dakota. Yesterday, they set a 2 p.m. evacuation date and time for people to get out of this main camp where everyone has been camped since August, since April, since almost coming up on a year ago. And yesterday they said they were going to evacuate it. They had news cameras all up at the main barricade up here. Let's see how far away the news cameras were. The news cameras were right there, about half a mile away. And so all they did is they marched down this road, and they marched and marched and marched and marched and marched until they met with water protectors, who someone called protesters, right about here, and then they just like scurried towards each other and backed off and scurried towards and backed off, and then they called it a day. And then the news left, the media left, no big surprise there, but they couldn't get a shot, they couldn't get what they were looking for out here because the rules for being out here are so strict, and trying to find our friend on the roof again. And so then today what happened is at about 11 a.m. they moved in full force with assault rifles, sniper rifles, and all sorts of things, all sorts of tools, one might say, to forcefully evacuate the camp. There were a lot of arrests made, a lot of people that stayed behind saying, "I'm not going to leave. If I'm going to leave, you're going to have to take me out of here." And so that's what's happening. And what I'm looking at this very moment is what I believe to be the last person left in the camp, who is sitting on the roof there, on that green roof, and just is not coming down, just waving a flag and not coming down. So that's what's going on. The noise you can hear right there probably is a U.S. Customs Border Patrol helicopter sweeping down. Let's see if I can find him here. Oh, it's long lens, tough. Coming down in for a look-see. There he is. I got a sniper out the side there.
Oh, yeah.
Well, when the door was open, there was a sniper going out the side. We're doing circles. And there's a second helicopter that's also flying above, a yellow one. Then there's also a plane that's flying above as well. That's pretty wild to see him kind of just disappear behind the hill like that. But where we are currently is, where is this guy? They're trying to negotiate with this guy to get him to come down, come down. And that's happening. Skater's gonna hate, skater's gonna skate. Troll's gonna troll. If you guys are not following a guy named Johnny Dangers, you should check him out. Johnny Dangers. He has a live feed going at this moment too. I'm not sure what of, I can't see it, but that's happening. If you guys are not following digital smoke signals, if you would like to have updates regarding this, those are my two recommendations for who to follow. And this guy is clearly getting spoken to and negotiated with, and I think they're gonna, who knows? Look at this. This is something else. Here's the Customs Water Patrol helicopter again. Those guys have been buzzing real low this whole time. Back to our friend on the roof. Please, come down, come down, come on. We got warm cookies and milk. Sorry, I've tried to stay very journalistic, professional during most of these streams, but at a certain point you're just like, oh man. What's going on? And cold humor alleviates the cold a little bit, in my opinion. So here I am cracking jokes to myself. To the best of my knowledge, yes, everyone else has left the camp or been arrested. I am recording this guy because he is who I believe to be the last one there. These guys keep throwing their arms up like, come on, man. What are you doing, dude? If you're just joining, again, we're here right now at Oceti Sakowin main camp. We are on Standing Rock Reservation, North Dakota. I am live streaming to you the red. And this morning the camp was cleared. Yesterday was the date and time that was set for clearing the camp, but it did not happen. In my opinion, there's too much media here for that to happen, because it would have given them what they wanted. So they waited an extra day, and here we are, fixing focus a little bit. And here we are today. The camp was swept by hundreds of police officers and security. I don't know. I can't tell you exactly what they were, but lots of people dressed in black, uniforms on, and assault rifles, some sniper rifles. You can see some of these guys right here that are, you know, clearly. Let's see if I can find a little group somewhere. Take the camera off of our roof guy for a minute. Let's see if we can find a little group of police around here somewhere. And there's one of the, like, you know, one of the vehicles. Where are the police? In large groups of them. Looking through the lens here, so I'm seeing what you're seeing. Guy is still on the roof. He's saying, nope, not doing it. This guy waving the flag. Like, these guys are bringing something in, apparently, it looks like, to try to be able to get to him. Not quite sure. I can't be sure about that, but I'm rolling right now. Yeah, I'm live right now.
Oh, you're live even. Taking a picture of the audio too.
Still going. These guys are still pulling foam or something in. I don't know whether it's to make him a landing pad or to try to reach up to him, but this is, as I've said, I believe the last person in camp. A lot of people willfully moved out the last couple days, moved their camps or relocated, etc. Then a good amount of people actually stayed yesterday. They said, if you're going to take me out, you're going to have to take me out. So I think that's the case with this young, or actually, I don't know if they're young, this person here on the roof. They're saying, you gotta take me out if you're gonna take me out. Guys, don't feed the trolls. This is just a friendly reminder. Do not feed the trolls on the feed. still some negotiation going on. Looks like they're saying, I don't know. I'm just trying to read some hand signals from the police officer on the left. It's like he's saying, okay, just come right this way. I promise there's a big foam pad here waiting for you when you slide off the roof. Still there.
Oh yeah, not stop.
Up, is he going down? Is the question.
Oh wow.
Not sure.
What are you guys flying? Well, I mean, that's the deal. Like, most of all your lift capacity is put to those batteries. You know, you get more energy. You're taking more energy than you're putting in. So, that thing's super light, but the battery is all of the weight. Yeah, nothing. All right. Push it twice. Hold the last one. Yep. Yeah, you did. Oh, and that helicopter's flying so low, he keeps on trying to smack into our drones. Like, I'm sure he would like to charge, they'd like to charge us with.
Here we, still up there.
And all of them are about the same. Because the DJIs, you gotta like push it and then hold it for a second. Just be real careful with that. With that chopper, I'm flying maybe 20 feet above the ground. Maybe.
Just so you guys know, I'm live right now with audio, so. In terms of.
Yeah.
That is a water protector on the roof, correct? That sound is the plane going overhead.
You can't hang around forever. Yeah, you're facing me before, but...
Sorry there. Where am I? Where'd I go? There he is. Still up there. A quick tour here. Let me see that. On quite a long lens, so everything is very compressed. You can see what remains of camp. Guys, just a friendly reminder here that trolls are going to troll. You get rid of trolls quite quickly if you don't feed the trolls. our friend here is still there. Open up our f-stop a little bit. A little brighter. That's a little better. Back. Alright, if you're just getting here, there is, we are live at Oceti Sakowin camp on Standing Rock Reservation, North Dakota. If you're wondering, is there someone on that roof? The answer is yes, there is someone on that roof. That person, I believe, is the last person that is still in the camp. They're holding a North Dakota flag, and they're sitting on the roof. I can't see obviously what's going on the other side, but here's where we're at. It's but just so you know, it's me turning the audio on and off. So you going down? I've given him a cable. We're gonna zoom in here, it'll go black for just a second. Hold on. You can see he's tying himself to a cable so he can slide down the hill. I'm sorry, slide down the roof, not slide down the hill. Rolled his flag up. Friendly reminder here, trolls are going to trolls. Trolls are going to troll. Don't feed the trolls. They're unfortunately rather sad, I imagine. And that's their problem and not yours. So let them be sad until they figure it out. And keep it positive. If you're here for positivity, keep it positive. Guys, slowly coming down. We go. Oh, that looks like a nice token effort there. Put the hand out, slow the fall. Well, thank you to whoever that was. Let's see if we see him getting walked out here. In just a second. All of you out there talking about jobs from the pipeline, the thing is, yes, it will bring in a lot of jobs for a very short amount of time. And then I think there's something like 80, I can't be quoted on the number, but there are less than 100 permanent jobs brought to the area from this pipeline. So if you want to talk about jobs, go talk about something else, because there are less than 100 permanent jobs being brought to this area. So fortunately, if you're talking the jobs game, you're talking about something that's not happening. You know, a couple thousand people employed to build it, no doubt, 100%, you're absolutely right. Where you're wrong there is that is not a lasting endeavor. So I'll just leave that there. framed up here, seeing if he's going to get brought out that way or not. No sign. Not yet, at least. For those of you just joining, I've been live streaming here, filming. There was one person left in camp sitting on a roof of a structure after what I believe is everyone else was either evacuated or arrested. This person was just still sitting there, sitting there, sitting there. So I've just been live streaming, just showing that last holdout. So you can see these police are walking away. I think that he is successfully down here. Low rumble, that's a plane flying overhead. Just going to reiterate that one more time. If you're here talking about jobs, it's going to bring jobs for the weeks that it takes, there's our guy. Never mind the jobs. Zooming in, it's going to go black for a second. It's a little grainy. There he goes, off into the paddy wagon. one more pan across the whole camp here. That's what used to be called Media Hill or Facebook Hill up here. Guys, leave Douglas alone. He's a sad person. Just leave him alone.
Where are you going?
Absolutely.
Yeah, you too.
Take it easy.
Still on the roof?
No.
No?
No, he went down.
Did they climb up to get him, or?
No, they sent him up like a cable to lower him down.
He just went for it?
Yeah.
What are you seeing now?
They're just forming a line, or?
No, that's pretty much been done. There is sound, I'm just not talking. He's got two flags that he just cut off of flagpoles in his hand.
What do you hope to do with all the information about it?
Sending it out.
Do you feel like it's... Do you feel like we can respond better in the future?